Welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Ran, and joining me today is Ariel from Sisense. Hi, Ariel.
Hi, Ran.
Before we dive into this, tell us a bit about Sisense.
Sisense is a BI company, allowing you to see the data that you have, that coming from different sources, understanding the data, modelizing the data, and getting insights from that data while maintaining the overall architecture.
Okay, so you have BI analysts going and using that dashboard, having all kinds of different data in it. They need to configure those different data sources in order to see them. How does that work behind the scenes?
So you have the users that seeing that information, okay? Different type of graph. Mm-hmm. But a lot of data comes from different type of sources, okay? Whether those sources are in the customer side, or web sources, or different locations. So that can be just a regular database inside the organization that you want to get in inside your Kubernetes clusters. Mm-hmm. Or that can be a redshift that's running in the same VPC that you want to get in that information. You have the S3 buckets that you want to expose by Athena, and you want to expose that coming also into your overall data. So you want to digest that data, okay, to manipulate the data, understanding that sometimes it's a spelling mistakes on the data. You want to say that the redshift column X is the same as column X over here, okay? They are coming from different sources. So you want to mesh all the data together and allowing the user at the end of the day getting the graph that this comes from this graph comes from here, here, and here. Mm-hmm. Doing that, you need the Sisense, all the ETL process that digest the data and keep it in a shared storage solution.
Okay, so as a shared storage solution, you're using FSx for Lustre. Tell us a bit about why you chose FSx for Lustre.
As you see that we have a lot of ingest comes in, okay? A lot of manipulation comes in. A lot of bin data need to be kept in a very fast way. A lot of our customers grab the data sometimes in every hour, sometimes every minute, 5 minutes, and digest all the data. We need a highly available solution that can be very, very fast responsiveness for keeping the data. Another process that gets the data from the shared storage and be able to answer the different clients on complex queries that happens in a milliseconds way. The way that we do that is we from that query service comes into the different shared storage area, memory mapped files, we manipulate the data and get the responses to the different type of clients.
Okay, so you can ingest the data at the backend either to an FSx for Lustre file system or to Redshift. How do you decide what to use and when?
So if the data is kind of a hot data that you need a lot of responses, very frequent in a milliseconds way, we use our ElastiCube logic that is in-memory database column now store. Mm-hmm. Okay, that mount directly from the FSx for Lustre. If the data is more as a warm data, massive number, size of data, terabytes of data, we use the Redshift as the warehouse database. And we can query directly to the Redshift.
Okay, so these workers are running inside containers on EKS clusters. Why did you choose containers and EKS for this workload?
We get a lot of automatic high availability, scale, resiliency, load balancing coming from the Kubernetes clusters. Every workload that we do can be sometimes small, can be huge, can take a lot of resources. Sometimes a lot of operation happen in parallel for the ingest and also for the query. Each one has its own timing and its own workload, okay? During the day comparing to during the night, so you do all kinds of manipulation. In order to do that in a very dynamically scalable solution, we utilize Kubernetes, the autoscalers of the pods, autoscalers of the nodes, everything is automatically scales, and Kubernetes see the workload and can inject additional compute as needed. They kind of be able to talk about big data analytics while having automatically scaling, that we gain from the FSx for Lustres because we very fastly mount from the FSx from Lustres and can serve the data faster.
Great. So in this case, why did you choose FSx for Lustre and not some other type of file system?
The additional capability for the FSx. So first, the FSx for Lustre is very, very fast responses, low latencies, a lot of throughput. Mm-hmm. But it also has capability to keep the data in the S3 bucket. So if you need a resiliency to bring up a different systems, you can just bring the system from that bucket. And you can back up that bucket and you can replicate that. So it's a very also efficient for disaster recovery.
Great, sounds good. So it sounds like you built a really resilient, fault tolerant, also highly performant at auto scaling system. Thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you, man.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.